Hello, my dear all student. How are you? I hope you're fine. And today, in this video, I'm going to tell you a very nice picture story. This story recalls the story of freedom through pictures. That means, what is a picture story? That means through the pictures and through the dialogues of the picture, you will be able to read this story. It also explains the idea that led to the first war of independence in 1857. You all know that our country got independence from British in 15 August 1947. But do you also know that India led to the first war of independence in 1957? Okay, so how this happened? What were the reason for the war of independence in 1857? So you will get a lot of knowledge, and you will also know something about your country, that how the Britishers came as a businessman and they became the ruler of our entire country. So, written by S.D. Sawant, and in a beautiful picture story style, he has explained the lesson, and you will find it very interesting. Lot of knowledge you will gain about our country, and in fact you will see our country is so rich in everything, in tradition, in culture, and it was known as Golden Bird. We were so rich. How everything comes to an end. So let's first of all, I told you Glimpses of the Past is written by S.D. Sawant, and this is a picture story. Now let me tell you the background of this picture story. So once again I repeat, it is a picture story. It recalls the story of freedom through pictures. It also explains the idea that led to the first war of independence in 1857. At a function in Delhi, Lata Mangeshkar sang patriotic song, "Ae Mere Watan Ke Logo." I think this song is very common. You must have heard during the time of independent Delhi, during the time of national festival. So this song is often heard by the people at that time. And children, this song, she pay homage to the freedom fighter. So at a function in Delhi, Lata Mangeshkar sang patriotic song, "Ae Mere Watan Ke Logo." She called upon the Indians to recall with tearful eyes the sacrifice of Indian freedom fighter. The English East India Company came to India for trade, but with its superior weapons of diplomacy, they extended its power in the 18th century. So they came as a trader in our country, okay, but they were very diplomat and they extended their power in the 18th century. Indian princes were divided and short-sighted. Okay, short-sighted means they never thought of future. People in India had no peace due to constant fights among the states of the country. And at that time, the misfortune of our country was that there used to be constant fight among the state of the country. They sought the help of the English merchants to defeat each other. Now children, they took the help of English merchants. Okay, they took the help of English merchants by buying their arms and ammunition, the modern weapons, and in this way, these rivalries helped the company to defeat and subdue Indian princes one by one. Now children, these rivalry means the fight, helped the company to defeat and subdue Indian princes one by one. Subdue means gain the power over somebody. A far-sighted ruler like the brave Tipu Sultan of Mysore fought the British till he died fighting. Children, but it doesn't mean that there were no rulers in our country. Of course, a brave person was there. Tipu Sultan, you must have heard, he was from Mysore and he fought the British till he died fighting. Now Indians reacted to the conquest made by the English company. Some of them thank God as well as the British for restoring peace in the country and stop looting. They said their destiny was linked with the English. Now children, at that time, two types of people were there in India. Two types of ideas were there in India. Two types of mentality of people you can see in the India. Earlier there used to be a lot of fight. The fight used to be between the state, the king of the state. They used to fight constantly. So the people, they were a financial loss. Nobody was at peace. So when these Britishers came, they controlled everything. In fact, they knew Indians to the conquest made by the English company. Some of them thank God as well as the British for restoring peace in the country. Now children, when British Indian came to the power, okay, there was a peace in the country. The Maharaja and the state king, they did not fight it. In fact, those who were fighted, the Britishers, what happened? They have taken their kingdom into their custody. So in this way, very less kings were left and the power of the king has gone in the hands of the Britishers. So there was some people thought ki now the fighting is not going on. So they are believed that they have restored peace in the country and stop looting. Children, the soldiers of the king, they used to loot each other. Okay, the soldiers which were winning, which were the winner, which win, they used to gain victory over the people. So this must they right used to have that they used to loot the people, they used to rob the people. So now this is also not there in the country. So many people think that the peaceful life is due to the Britishers. So, and what there are other types of people who with a different mentality, and they used to feel unhappy. They complained that the white men had killed or dethroned their king. What they used to feel that they either they had killed their king or they have thrown them from their kingdom, they have thrown them from their power. Okay, they have put them in their jail. No doubt some kings were bad, but after all they were Indians. Now children, people started realizing, oh, that king was not good, but anyhow he was an Indian. And under the white rulers they had become slaves. And now children, who were white rulers, the Britishers, and the whole country became slaves to them. Some religious leaders supported the social evils such as untouchability and child marriage. Okay, now children, at that time some religious leaders were also there who, and so many social evils were present in the country, but this was not looked after by the British government. So these religious leaders, these were some of the problem of the society, like untouchability and child marriage. These were there. Okay, so they were looking after these things, these problems of the society. They forbade crossing the seas and going abroad. In fact, British did not want that the Indians should go cross the sea and they should go abroad. They had a fear, suppose if they will go to another country, then the trade will, suppose if they started doing trade with other country, because at that time, children, India was very rich. Lot of silk, spices, tea, jewels, jewelries, diamonds, so many things were there in India. Spices, okay. So many people wanted to have trade with us. That was the reason they forbade. Forbade means not allowed, crossing the sea and going abroad. A few said that the women were to blame for all the misery. some of them had told that all this thing happened due to they were supposed to blame for all the misery. The truth was that Indians had lost self-respect. The white hated and disbelieved them. And children, the fact was that we had lost our self-respect. Okay, we were fighting among ourselves, and these people, they were taking advantage. The white hated and disbelieved them. The English were merchants first. Their aim was to make quick profit. Now children, though they were the rulers of India, but many Britishers have this idea that they should become rich. So in fact, they were merchant first. The aim was to make quick profits. So what they have done, they imposed heavy taxes on the farmers. So they have put a heavy tax on the farmers. Okay. And if the farmers, if they were not able to pay the taxes in time, they used to throw them in the jail for failing to pay their taxes arrears. They destroyed Indian cottage industries also in order to sell good manufactured in England. Now children, the other important thing was that Indian cottage industries, it was all destroyed due to the Britishers, because they were selling their own country's thing. They did not allow that. They had made some rule that the things belonging from our country would not be sold. They exempted all goods imported from England from duties. Now children, not only that, whatever good was coming from England, they exempted it from their duties. Duties means the heavy taxes. Now there was no need to pay heavy taxes on the good which came from England. It was made duty free. Thus they ruined Indian artisans and their business. And children, they had made such a policy that our merchants and their business started deteriorating. They became the sufferers. They ruined Indian artisans and their business. Ram Mohan Roy, a learned social reformer from Bengal, understood what was going with the country. Now children, it was Ram Mohan Roy. He was a far-sighted person. Okay. He predicted everything, okay, and he was a learned social reformer also. Social reformer, that means reformer means the person who can change the society. So he was a learned social reformer from Bengal, understood what was going with the country. Now he was so intelligent that he judged that what is happening in his country. He called upon the people to feel proud of their ancient culture and get the society rid of silly superstitions. Now he told the people to feel proud of their ancient culture. Don't adopt the culture of Britishers. And he wanted that the society should get rid of silly superstition. He pointed out that all religions preach the same thing. He understood the importance of science and modern knowledge. He started newspaper, but the British stopped them in 1823. He crossed the seas and went to England to see what made the British so powerful. He then adopted the middle path. He agreed to accept the British as ruler, but they must remember the responsibility of rulers towards their subject. Now children, he was a very mere person in front of the British rulers, so he tried to convince the people that predict the future, one day they will started ruling over us. They have already started ruling over them, over Indians, and the situation will be worse day by day. Okay. And children, he was did not believe the superstitions as it was prevailing at that time in India. And not only that, so many problems were there which a society has to face. So he was also among one of them who was trying to solve the problem of the society or of the country. Now he knew, okay, and he was a person who crossed the sea and he went to see England what made the British so powerful. He then adopted the middle form. He agreed to accept the British as ruler, but they must remember the responsibility of rulers toward their subject. Now children, he accepted them their ruler, though he was reluctant. Okay, but then he thought ki if he will not accept them as a ruler, then something will happen to him. So he told, but he was a very brave person. He then adopted the middle path. He agreed to accept the British as rulers, but they must remember the responsibility of rulers towards their subject. From 1775 to 1835. So remember the date, from 1775 to 1835, the Britishers continued to oppress Indians. So from 1765 to 1835, the Britishers, what they did, they continued to oppress Indians. In 1818, they passed a resolution under which an Indian could be jailed without trial. The British officer in India reduced salaries and also made fortunes in private business. As a result, Britain prospered while Indian's industries began to decline. Governor General Bentinck wrote back home about the starving cotton weavers. And children, this was proved when Governor General Bentinck, he wrote something about his policy to in his house, and he told that he was happy to see the cotton weavers starving. If starving means they have ruined their policy due to, with the help of their British policy, they have ruined the cottage industry system, and these weavers, the person who weaves the clothes, they are starving. Starving means die due to hunger. Indians were taught Persian and Sanskrit. Now children, Indians were taught at that time two language, Persian and Sanskrit. In 1835, an Englishman named Macaulay recommended the teaching of English in India. And children, till now, the whole Indians, they were taught in either in Persian or Sanskrit. But in 1835, an Englishman, and his name was Macaulay, he recommended the teaching of English in India. English education produced clerks who were given petty jobs, but it also produced a set of intellectuals. They said that Indians should learn English, they should improve the economic condition, and they conveyed their grievances to the British Parliament. So such were the policies of Britishers. Now they are attacking our mother tongue. They wanted that the English should be the main teaching of Indian school. Okay, they started giving importance to their language. By 1856, the British had conquered the whole of India. They cared little about the welfare of Indians. Indian kings and rulers became puppets of the British. The people had lost all jobs and lands. They felt the need to drive the white men out. The Santhalas revolted in 1855 and killed many Europeans. The Indian soldiers in the British army. Naturally, these are the drawbacks which I am telling you. Okay, that by 1856, what was the condition of our country? The British has conquered the whole country. They came as a trader, they came as a merchant, and now what was the situation in 1856? Everything was conquered by Britishers. They have overpowered India, the whole country. They cared little about the welfare of Indian children. They were busy in looting India, in making their own profit by putting lot of taxes. Okay, but they only care very little about the welfare of Indians. Indian kings and rulers became puppet of the British, and children, their policies was such a policy that the Indian remaining Indian kings and princes, they had become the puppets in the hands of the Britishers. The people had lost all jobs and land. In fact, all the jobs and lands after land, people were losing. They felt the need to drive the white men out. Now, children, they felt that this is the time to throw them outside the country. It was our country and they are overpowering us. It was our country, but we were losing the job. It was our country, the land were injured, the whole land were conquered by them. So that was a time that the whole Indian felt the need to drive the white men out. Zantha Santhal, they revolted in 1855 and killed many Europeans. The Indian soldiers in the British army were also dissatisfied because they were poorly paid. Now, children, there were many Indian soldiers, and these Britishers, they took under them, and even they were not satisfied because they used to get a very less payment, pay scale. They were poorly, very poor wages they used to get. They were sent to other countries. Okay. And if some war used to be there on behalf of the Britishers, these Indians, they used to go. They were forced to go to the other country to fight for the British, for the Britishers. The Indian soldiers in the British army were also dissatisfied because they were poorly paid. They were sent to other countries. Sipahi Mangal Pandey attacked the white and was hanged. Children, one of the Sipahi Mangal Pandey, he was a patriotic post, full of patriotism he had with, okay. So he revolted, he attacked the white, and now he was ordered to be hanged. Thousands of other Sipahis were also put in chains. The Brahmin soldiers came to know that their bullet had fat of cows and pigs. The message was sent from village to get ready for the revolt. The Sipahi marched to Delhi and accepted Emperor Bahadur Shah as their head. The rebellion spread. Many landlords also joined it. Begum Hazrat Mahal of Lucknow and Azimullah Khan, Peshwa Nana Sahab, Kuwar Singh of Bihar pitched battles all over North India. So did the people in Bareilly, Kanpur and Allahabad. This marked the beginning of India's first war of independence. So children, in this lesson you came to know what about the first Indian war of independence, that how our people had revolted against them, how a war started between Indians and Britishers. Okay, so this was the background of the lesson. And now we will come to the which part? We'll come to the picture story part. So as you can see in this book, all right, first of all, the name of the lesson is Glimpse of the Past. What do you mean by glimpse? Glimpse means to look at. So through this picture story, the writer want you to look at the past, what really happened, how people sacrificed their life, how so many people were killed. The children, now we are eating, we are leading a happy life in our country, now we are independent. But then who were the real heroes who helped India to gain independence? Who were those people? Okay, they have left their jobs of their state, and their only dream was to revolt and throw the Britishers out. So let's read before you read. Here are some pictorial glimpses of the history of our country from 1757 to 1857. So children, this is a pictorial form, and you can see so many pictures are there, and you can also see the dialogues which is written here. These dialogues you have to see and read. Okay, so the pictures and speech bubble, that means a bubble will be there. You can see a bubble is there. This is known as bubble. Will help clarify your understanding of the condition. Now this bubble is there, and you can see a small arrow here, which prove that she is speaking. Here are some pictorial glimpses of the history of our country from 1757 to 1857. Now children, 1757 to 1857, nearly 100 years. Okay, what happened in India? These pictures and speech bubble will help clarify your understanding of the condition that led to the event known as the First War of Independence in 1857. So what happened? Okay, we only help Britishers. They followed the divide and rule policy, and finally we all became slaves. They overpowered and they started ruling us. So let's read the speech bubbles and find out who is saying what. Children, you can see the arrow. Okay, you can see here a arrow is there. Look, it is coming here. This arrow is here. This shows that this whole speech bubble, what is there written, it is coming. It is she who is speaking, who is having a paper in her hand. She is actually Lata Mangeshkar, the great Indian singer. So she sang, she is about to sing A Meri Vatan Ke Logo, and you can see Mrs. Gandhi, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. She is the daughter of Jawaharlal Nehru. Then here who is sitting? You should recognize all these great fellows. Here who is sitting? Lal Bahadur Shastri, Mrs. Gandhi, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. The late Prime Minister, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Here Jawaharlal Nehru. And here Lata Mangeshkar. Okay, and she is giving homage to the person, to the soldiers who had lost their life in the war. And you can see the bubble is coming towards Lata Mangeshkar. An arrow is something like an arrow is there, which shows that she is speaking. Okay, now the martyrs. Children, what is the meaning of martyrs? The person who died in the war, jo shaheed ho jate hain. So the martyrs, okay, at a function in New Delhi, a function is there in New Delhi, and what Lataji is saying, she's saying, oh my countrymen, let your eyes fill with tears as you all recall the sacrifices of India's martyrs. Now she is telling that our eyes will fill with tears, okay, when I will tell you that how the heroes, our soldiers, has sacrificed their life for our India's martyrs. Now, should I start explaining here from here? So first chapter is there. That Lata ji, she is saying what? She is saying, oh my countrymen, let your eyes fill with tears as you recall the sacrifice of Indian's martyrs. Now she is telling, when you will listen the Indian martyrs, eyes will fill with tears. And today I am going to give sacrifice through this song to all Indian martyrs. So in this way, she started in the function. Now Jawaharlal Nehru, you can see All right, so many freedom fighters, you can see, like here you can see Bahadur Shah Jaffa. You can see many people here, Bahadur Shah Jaffa, you can see in the picture, and I hope you recognize her, the Queen of Jhansi. Okay, Bhagat Singh, Subhash Chandra Bose, the father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi. Here he is, Bahadur Shah Jaffar, Pandit Nehru. This is Gokhale, and this I am not able to recognize. Who is he? Okay, I am not able to remember. In fact, I am able to recognize, but I am not able to remember his name. So many people I have shown you. Okay, they were involved with the in fact they were all the freedom fighters, and due to them we got our freedom. So with this part of the video I end. Wait for the second part of the video and then you will enjoy this picture story. So thank you, and read and listen to our video, please children. Please don't, without reading your English will be very weak. So love English, enjoy English, and learn English. Now thank you and for listening the video, and children, now I'm going to end with this video.